What's up, crawlers? It's Crawler Baller. Don't forget to subscribe to this channel.
What's going on, guys? It's Crawler Baller here. Doing a video because obviously I'm super obsessed with these SCX24 Ford Broncos. And instead of tricking out the tires and going huge, I thought I would do a little street legal segment. Because I thought that these street tires looked pretty sick, especially on my course, which is pretty much just kind of a little trail course anyways. It's not a super technical course, although there are some technical elements to it, but it's mostly just kind of a little scale thing. So here's a little look around if you haven't been here before. And if you're new to the channel, thank you so much for stopping by. And I want to say a special thank you to my first 1,000 subscribers. And this is going to be going out to subscriber number 904, Fixer. Thank you so much for being one of my first 1,000 subs. You are the winner. I'll get this out to you as soon as I can. So let's get to this video here. I'm going to start with the RC four-wheel drive dirt grabber all-terrain tires, which I got a long time ago. I can't remember what I got them for. Maybe it was for C10 or something like that. And I tried them out. Obviously, they look really cool, but they're not very tready. But they look pretty much like something you would see out on the street, so qualifies as street legal. Gonna make our way across this little bridgey bridge and over to excuse me, man, I don't even know how I lost my voice, but for some reason my voice is real scratchy today, so excuse that. But anyways, getting over to this little rock pile there, that was actually not too bad, not too shabby. You know, there's a lot of people that have been saying online that these Ford Broncos are not very capable, which, I mean, I guess compared to what? I don't know. Compared to your super tricked out, you know, $1,000 in SCX24 deadbolt? Yeah, I would agree with that. But compared to basically any other crawler on the face of the earth at this scale, I think that even this Bronco outperforms anything else I've got in its stock form, if that makes any sense. So if you're talking like the Hobby Plus, the CR24s, even the the Panda Hobby one, the Kyosho Mini Z's, the WPLs for sure. So I've been through a bunch of mini crawlers, and even though this one is not the best performing SCX24 there is, I guess you can argue that, I would say that even with these really tiny tires, it's still better than anything else you will find out there. So if you're looking to get into getting an SCX24, I would just recommend getting whichever one that you think looks the coolest, because they're all basically the same, minus, you know, different link sizes and stuff like that, but they're all basically the same. They perform great. They're all very upgradable. So that's my rant on that. Check out that little flex. So now moving over to these Vulcan Wild Peak MT tires, and they're also on the RC four-wheel drive stamped beadlocks, I think that's what these things are called. They have about a quarter more tread than those dirt grabbers, and you can already tell, or at least I can already tell, making our way up that little spine was a lot easier. Still a pretty street legal looking rig. Now it's driving me nuts that the spare tires don't match the wheels on the car, but it's all right. I forgive myself. Yeah, these giant slippery boulders are always a giant nightmare until they start adding tires that are a lot bigger around. And there's a lot of weight on the back of this thing, so I think when I use my Ultra Brute, it's kind of a truggy kind of thing, so there's not much weight in the back at all. It just kind of lifts over these obstacles very easily, so that would be a difference. Maybe next time I do a video, I'll add some bigger tires to these, and then I might compare them to, say, the Gladiator or the Ultra Brute, or maybe even the Kyosho Mini Z. Because I think that would be worth looking into, especially when you start adding in these hard bodies and all the weight on top. It does make them perform a little bit more like some of the other models that I discussed earlier. However, the underneath, the SCX24 platform is just so dang nice. It kind of makes it just always gonna be a better choice than anything out there. And if you disagree, please let me know in the comments below. I would love to hear what you think the best platform in this scale is, or within a few different scales. 18th scale, 28th scale. But overall, not a bad run. And look at these. These things have a good little flex coming out of the box. It's a nice run. So next week, I'm going to be doing a video adding these TSL boggers to the mix. I'm sure it's going to make them a lot more capable. But we'll have to see. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you again soon. Peace.